Going to 10.5, we are now dealing with rationalizing denominators. When I talked about dealing with fractions, I always said, simplify if it's perfect squares. If it's not, can you simplify underneath by simplifying the fraction? And last but not least, we're going to rationalize the denominator. So we always want to simplify first if we can. Remember, the rule for simplifying means we cannot have a radical left in the denominator. So our last resort is to rationalize the denominator. So I want to remind you, if we had a half, I can multiply by 2 over 2 to rewrite that as 2 fourths. I can multiply as long as I multiply the same thing, numerator and denominator. So my goal is to make the denominator a perfect square so that it will go away. So looking at number 1, I can't simplify anything there. I'm going to multiply the numerator and denominator by square root of 7 because that's going to give me a perfect square in the denominator of 49, which does simplify. I cannot cancel the 7 and 7 because one is underneath the radical and one is not. Now, number 2, there is multiple ways to do this. However, you want to simplify first if you can. So what I mean by that is 12 is the same thing as 4 times 3. So I can pull out a 2 and the 3 is left. That is my product, 4 times 3. So the product rule says I can take the square root of 4, which gives me the 2. Now notice I have a 6 on the outside and a 2 on the outside. So I can simplify those. Gives me a negative 3 over radical 3. Now it is simplified as far as it can go. I want to make it fit a perfect square, which it does now with a square root of 9 by multiplying by square root of 3 over square root of 3. 3 comes out. Again, be careful. These are on the outside, so I can simplify. My answer for this problem should be a negative square root of 3. Could you have multiplied by square root of 12 first? Yes, but you're creating a lot more work of simplification in the later steps, but it will work. So again, if that's the way that clicks with you, you can use it. Just make sure you simplify completely. Looking at number 3, we have the square root of 18 over 5y. I want to simplify this first. This is 9 times 2y. Sorry, 9 times 2 over 5y. So the 3 comes out. I have the square root of 2 in the numerator and the square root of 5y in the denominator. I have now simplified it as far as I can go. I need to rationalize the denominator so that I am finished with simplifying and don't break one of my rules. So I'm going to multiply the top and bottom by the square root of 5y. That's going to give me 3 square root of 10y over the square root of 25y squared. Again, by design, I've made it fit a perfect square. So I'm left with 3 square root of 10y over 5y. I cannot reduce this. This is underneath the radical. This is not. That is my answer. These problems, you need to slow down. You need to simplify first. When you skip steps, you're more likely to make a mistake. So looking at 1 through 3, we had monomials in the denominator, one term. Looking at 4 and 5 and 6, we are dealing with rationalizing denominators with a binomial in the denominator. So in order to rationalize these denominators, we will multiply by the difference of squares idea. Stop and remember, back in 10.4, when we dealt with difference of the squares, the radical disappeared, and that's my goal. So I'm going to multiply by the conjugate of the denominator. If I have a plus b, my conjugate is a minus b. I'm just changing my sign to make it fit a difference of squares. So for number 4, I'm going to always start off by putting parentheses around any binomial. I'm going to multiply by the conjugate of the denominator. Has to be numerator and denominator. By design, this will always be a difference of squares in the denominator. So that's a 4 and a radical 3. That gives me 16 minus 3. Be careful, this is squaring the number. This gets rid of the square root for the square root of 3 squared. So I end up with a 13 in the denominator. You can go ahead and distribute the 5 on the top if you want to, but in this case, remember, my goal is to see if I can simplify. So if it's in factored form, that's going to help me to see if I can simplify. The 5 doesn't simplify here. So this answer is okay, or 20 plus 5 radical 3 over 13 is okay. Have to multiply by its conjugate. Looking at number 5, notice I start off with putting parentheses around every binomial so that I'm not confused with what I'm multiplying by. So I'm now going to multiply by square root of 5 minus square root of 3, numerator and denominator. Denominator will always fit a difference of squares. Square root of 5 squared, those cancel. Square root of 3 squared cancels. So I end up with a 2 in the denominator. Now I am going to distribute on the top because in this case I'm going to FOIL because there's not going to be a factored form to be able to simplify with that 2. So this is going to give me square root of 10 minus square root of 6. Minus square root of 15, be careful, plus the square root of 9. Square root of 9 is the only piece I can simplify there. That is my answer. Have to multiply by its conjugate pair. So number 6, put my parentheses around any binomial, multiply by its conjugate pair, which means the opposite sign. Again, in this case, I'm going to leave it in this factored form with the monomial so that I can see if I can simplify at the end. This denominator is going to be, again, difference of squares. So that's going to give me an m minus p. Nothing to combine there. That is my answer. Remember, please, always multiplying, if it's a binomial, times its conjugate pair. Okay? Has to be that to fit a difference of squares. That is the only way that the radicals disappear in the denominator.